This is the first Q7 with an S badge.
Plump and fat.
There is something really weird going on with my steering. What the hell is that? You can't go to the left. I kind of want one. What's up, everyone? Welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we're taking a look at the Audi SQ7. And we have driven it before at MTM with 505 horsepower, but we haven't driven the stock one yet. So we thought, you know, it was time that we took this for a drive. Of course, we have driven its sibling, the Bentley Bentayga diesel, which is sort of the same car, but you know, the Bentley is a lot more luxurious and this is supposed to be a bit more sporty. So let's take a look at the spec. We borrowed it at JC Baarse in the Netherlands. This one is for sale over there. So if you're interested, go check it out. They've got a lot of special Audis and a bit more other stuff as well. The spec. This is called Floret Silver, which I really like. I think it's a beautiful color, especially in combination with all those black details around the car here on the side. The window sills, the roof rack. These windows are very tinted. They are also isolated, which is very nice because it's very quiet. This is in black as well. I think that is always in black though. SQ7 badge, quad exhaust pipes. This is the key SQ7 logo as well. Very cool. It's a very handsome car, I have to say. It is a lot less obese than the previous Q7, which was a bit plump and fat. And yeah, this is much more sleek than the previous one. I really like it. And it's rather huge, this car, but you don't see it like you did with the old one. So big grille here with an SQ7 badge. This is black as well, which is nice. Yeah, I have to say it is a very handsome car, especially in SQ7 trim, which makes it even more sporty. Very cool. And as I said, it is very big. Ooh. So if we open this one, you can see that it has a very large boot with these little rollers, which are an option as well. And you can divide the luggage space like this, and you know, you can prevent stuff from going all the way back and rolling around. But as you can see, this is actually a 7-seat version. So if I press those two buttons, these two seats fold up and you can do the headrest like that. And it's actually not bad. It is for two children, it's okay. And you can also adjust this one. So if you have larger children, you can, you know, divide it a bit. But it is actually very spacious in the back here, and we have these seats very far back. So space-wise, this is rather impressive. So let's fold them down. We don't need the space. Okay, let's take a look at the interior. So as I said, a lot of space here. Big panoramic roof, some climate controls there. This car also has the heated seats in the rear. And it has SQ7 badges down there. So these seats, let's start with those. These are the comfort seats. So as standard, you get a bit more sporty ones. But if you go for massage seats or ventilated seats, which this has both of them, you get these seats instead, because it's not possible with the sportier seats. Other than that, we've got this oak wood inlay combined with sort of a brushed aluminium, which I like. I really like. I think it's quite nice. Better than all that carbon fiber we've been seeing lately. I like this better in an SQ7, in a Q7 in general. So, what else? We've got the virtual cockpit over there and this old screen right here, which I don't really get. I mean, you have this super advanced technology virtual cockpit thing and then you just pop the old screen on there and, you know, it's just not okay. So luckily you can stow it away, which I prefer. Okay, so what else? The engine. And oh, I forgot something in the rear as well. Okay. So if you check out this, it has a little cubby here, or cubby, not really a cubby, but this is where the 48 volt electrical system is housed. I think this is part of it, and this is actually part of the Bose system. So I think this is a subwoofer, and I think this is an amplifier, or at least some kind of computer to, you know, work it all. So no extra room here, and this is also why this car has 60 to 65 liters less luggage space than a regular Q7, because all that stuff is down there to make room for the 48 volt electrical system. And if we take a look under here, we don't really see anything, but it is a V8 TDI 4 liter diesel engine with two turbos and an electrical compressor. So I have spoken about this. I have tried to explain how it works in the Bentley Bentayga diesel review. So check that one out up here if you want to learn more about how this works and about all the technological stuff that's gone into this engine and this car in general. Because as I said, it's sort of the same drivetrain and there are some similarities, or a lot of similarities. But, you know, short version is that it has two regular turbochargers in the hot V, so inside the cylinder bank. It also has an electrical compressor that is powered by a 48 volt electrical system. And it has active stabilizers that decouple when you go straight and that couple when you go into a corner, and that system is also powered by that 48 volt system. So it's very clever, it's very high tech, and it is very complicated, but I think I did a pretty good job explaining it in the Bentley Bentayga POV review. So that link you saw like a minute ago up there, go check that out if you want to learn more. That was sort of an abbreviated version of it. But let's see how all that tech adds up in this car. What is this car like to drive? And let me just... okay, so I can keep this on. I'll just open the windows. And we'll switch from comfort to dynamic. Okay, listen to this. This is regular. I don't know if you can actually hear that. Okay, so let's go back to comfort. Okay, not that much sound. Back to dynamic. There's some more sound, and it has some kind of sound actuator that amplifies sound or produces sound, which is, you know, I don't know if I like it, but it's there. They clearly want to make this SQ7, you know, a sporty diesel SUV, which I don't know if that's even possible, but anyway. Alrighty. So, 4.8 seconds to 100 kilometers an hour, 250 kilometers an hour top speed. Those are not bad numbers. And there is something really weird going on with my steering. What the hell is that? So I'm in dynamic mode, and I think that the dynamic mode also changes the steering feel, because it is comically heavy and really, really jumpy. That is very weird. It's like someone is pulling on the steering wheel, you know, in the opposite direction. So, oh, that is not good. Wow, okay, so. No, that is not good at all. Okay, let's go to sport for the gearbox. We've got a ZF 8-speed linked to that 4-liter V8 diesel engine. And we'll try the manual shifts for a sec. Okay, yeah, they are really quick. Downshift, very good as well. Okay, so nothing new there. This gearbox is still incredible, but this is amazing. Okay, so the steering is really bad. It is really, really weird, but the way this thing corners is super impressive. It stays completely flat, even more than the Bentayga diesel did, which also had that 48-volt active stabilizer system. But in this one, I think that it's, you know, even stiffer or even more present. Very impressive. And you do get a nice V8 rumble from that engine, because earlier when I opened the windows, you could clearly hear that the sound was coming from the rear, that weird, deeper sound that sounds a little bit fake. But, oh man, this steering is heavy. Why? Why would you do that? So stupid. All right, let me just switch to comfort. Yeah, that's way better. Oh. It's still a bit, it has a very aggressive return to the center position. I don't know if you can see that, but if I let go of the steering wheel, it's very aggressive. It's like there's some kind of spring on there, a very powerful spring that says, no, you can't go to the left. No, you can't go to the right. Okay, whatever. Let's go to dynamic. So while we're driving on this lovely road, let me just tell you something about our watch brand. It's called Ignition. It's sort of our merchandise. So if you want to support us, you don't buy a hat or a t-shirt, you can buy a watch. Because we think it's more fun and more, you know, linked to cars as well. Because most people who like cars also like watches, or men in general, I would say. So click the link in the top right corner to go to the website, and you can check out the watches we have. Right now we've got two models, but there's a new one coming soon. And we really want to build a collection. So if you're interested, go check it out. And with that said, let's do a launch control, or a launch. Okay, a little slow initially, and then it picks up. All right, that is quite fast. And all that magic under the bonnet means that this car is 435 horsepower and 900 newton meters, which is, you know, that is a lot, 900 newton meters. That is also why this car has that ZF 8-speed, because that S-tronic can't handle that much torque. And, well, I said I would drop that ridiculous steering, but of course, you can use the individual setting of the drive selector. So you can set everything to sport, to its most sporty setting, and then select comfort for the steering, which is something I would recommend anyone who is going to drive this car, even if you're only driving it for 4 minutes, because this steering is ridiculous. The predecessor of this car, of course, was the Audi Q7 V12 TDI, but this is the first Q7 with an S badge. And well, this car is, of course, a lot more sophisticated. It's a lot more smooth and a lot more technologically advanced. Although that V12, of course, in its day was very impressive and even was a race-derived engine, which is also very special for a diesel, of course. But this car is much more sporty than that Q7 V12 TDI. We drove that on this road as well, and it just felt huge and fat and sluggish. So this car is really deserves that S badge. And it's a good thing that they didn't go for that S badge on that V12 TDI version. If you want to check out the POV review of that car we made, click up here and then you can come back and see how much has changed and, you know, how far we've come in just a couple of years. Well, 10 years. And another thing that could improve the steering feel is the 22-inch wheel you can get. So as standard, it comes with a 21-inch wheel, which we have today. But, you know, the steering feel is completely dead. You don't feel anything. That's also because it is so heavy and so, you know, over the top. So maybe if you would go for that 22-inch wheel, your front would get a little bit sharper and the turn-in would be a little bit sharper as well. Because with a 22-inch wheel, you also get a skinnier tire. The thing I love about this car is that it is very effortless, so it is very quiet. I don't know if you can hear that, or if you can judge how quiet it is. But there's very little noise coming from the tires, very little from the windows and the mirrors. Also because it has that extra thick isolated glass. But it is a very comfortable car, and it's not, you know, sporty in the sense that you want to drive 10 laps on the Nordschleife. It's more like sporty that you can take corners at very high speeds, but it's still very, very comfortable. It's not that much less comfortable than the Bentley Bentayga, I would say, but it does feel a little more sporty. So this little S corner right there, I'm just going to see what happens at higher speeds. So no one coming in the opposite direction. No, okay. So this is really impressive how flat this car stays. I mean, that 48 volt system, it is very complicated, but it does really work. Interior wise, it's very Audi. It's a bit cold, very sort of, I would almost say Swedish design or Danish design, whatever, Scandinavian design. It's very minimalistic. But it feels very spacious. And oh man, that steering! I just I don't even want to drive this car anymore. It is so stupid. Oh, it's how has this passed any checks at Audi? How is it possible that there hasn't been one person who said, okay, this is not acceptable? Why? Oh man, okay, sorry, I'm going to drop it now. So interior, super spacious, it's super comfortable, nice leather, you can get leather everywhere. But this car is actually very expensive, so I don't, you know, there's nothing you can take away from this, but this car starts at 130,000 euros in the Netherlands. This car was 205,000 euros, so I think it has nearly every option except from the leather on the dash, on top of the dash, because down here is all leather. But it is very expensive. But the thing is, you do feel it and you do see it. And, you know, compared to the old Q7, this is a major step up. I mean, this isn't even in the same league as the previous one. The only thing, as I said, is that this screen is a bit old, it's a bit dated. And, you know, with that virtual cockpit, I would say that invest a little bit more and go for a new version of that old screen as well. Okay, did I miss anything? I don't think so. I hope you enjoyed this video. Ooh, fun fact. Okay, did I miss anything? It has quattro, of course, as standard, but you can also get a sport differential for the rear, which has torque vectoring. So it brakes the inside wheel to, you know, to make you corner better and to make it feel a bit less huge, a bit more agile. It also has four-wheel steering. It has that 48-volt system. You know, there are a lot of things going on underneath to make this car feel smaller than it really is, and it works. It drives incredibly well and it's super comfortable. It's one of the nicest driving SUVs I've ever driven. So yeah, there you go. New SQ7, a lot better than the previous Q7, and I kind of want one. Okay, that's it. I hope you enjoyed it. You can subscribe by clicking the big button right here. You can also check out this POV review of the Bentley Bentayga diesel, and you can check out this POV reviews playlist. We've made a lot of these, so if you enjoyed this one, go check it out. Thanks guys, see you at the next one. Bye.